You're going to join me in the first reveal. I don't know what this box looks like yet, and you're going to find out along with me. Ta-da. Okay. Get some light on the job. Okay, I mean, from a long way back, it looks okay. When you get closer, not so good. Mind you, a lot of that will polish out. Let's see. Yeah, I mean, a lot of this surface stuff is a bit rubbish, but you can see now it looks dead shiny and glossy, but it's not flat at all, so it needs flatting back, probably another coat, and then flatted back and polishing. Here's that run we had. I'm hoping that that will, well, that we can improve that with a bit of sanding. It's just going to be dry sanding, no wet sanding. Okay, so that's the first reveal. Quite shiny, you can see a reflection of the, well, of my arm and of the seats of the Goldwing there. But it is going to need quite a bit of polishing. These corners look nice though, but there are deficiencies in the surface. Ah, it's okay. Yeah. I'm not too upset. That's good. Right. I'm going to pause you while I set up the tripod and park you. Well, actually, you know what? I can just do that. There you go. Oh, good grief. There you go. Right. We'll get the microphone doodle on. So, switch my mic on. Plug the receiver in. Okay, looks like we've got sound. Go with the hat again. Brought eye protection this time. Can you see that? Yeah, you can. So that's good. What a kettle. Right, I need to get this microphone secured. I think once the battery dies, then another time the battery died and it was nowhere near the 2 hour mark. But another time the battery had not died and you still left me. Left me all on my lonesome, so I'm not quite sure what happened there. I still had memory left, apparently enough to record another 30 minutes of video if I'd wanted to. But maybe there's a safety cutout. I'm recording at 720p, 30 frames a second, on a Samsung Galaxy S22. I'm not sure what that means in terms of if there's a limit and it cuts out. I believe some phones, when they're recording on 4K, they have something like a 6 minute cutout to stop them overheating. Don't think that's going to be the case here. 2 hours seems like too long for an overheating type of a concern. Right, let's have a look. Yeah, gonna go straight in on this side. The great thing about reviewing the video later, I got to see just how clearly you could see that paint getting wet on the surface when I was blowing it on. I couldn't see it as well as that. So, what does that tell you? Well, maybe my eyes aren't that good, and maybe I should get some better lighting in here. More better lighting in here. I think that's fair. I think the next time I'm doing any paint spraying, I'll set up my work lights. Whether I do that for this final coat of lacquer, because I intend this to be the final coat of lacquer, I don't know. Compressor not plugged in. Yeah, compressor plugged in. Compressor switched on. Oh, just needs turning off, I think. Again, touching it with my stupid greasy fingers. Shouldn't be doing that. There you go. You can see straight away it looks pretty bad, actually. I'm breaking the glaze on the lacquer, which does seem to have set hard enough. It's very cold in here, but it's been a few days. It's two-pack lacquer, so it has a catalyst to help the reaction. I wasn't sure how long to leave it. This seems to be okay, though. Going to try to be a bit more disciplined in my sanding, keep it all in one direction. I mentioned last time about adding paint to the run to try and let it settle out. And I seem to recall when I had success in getting the paint to settle like that, I did remember later that I went on to have issues because there was too much paint, so it didn't dry by the time I wanted to sand it. So I was breaking the surface of the paint and then sanding into paint that hadn't hardened, which just wasn't working at all. Trying not to touch this horizontal surface too much. It's not necessarily all that easy. I wonder if the other pad might be better. Oh, I suppose I should check what you can see. Oh yeah, that's okay. Yeah, that's okay. Yeah, I just wonder if it will only be touching the foam parts then. Might have missed again. I think I'm okay on this side though. In this one area, I do want to break through the paint around these runs. I do want to try and flat them back a touch. Well, flat them right back, really. Don't want to go too hard because this is. I'm still on 400 grit. Oh, I did mean to bring some other grits with me. So it's going pretty smooth. It's going pretty smooth under my fingers. I can barely feel a lot of the original run. Like there, I can't feel hardly anything at all. That last uptick, I can feel quite a bit. You can still see the dust piling up. The internal corner along the bottom is quite bad. Just a very poor finish, poor surface finish. We might be down to fingertips now. Just getting in locally and sanding the high spots off with a bit more local pressure. Local pressure for local issues. Brake had gone through to primer there. Bit of black primer on that surface. Showing through. At least the screws still come out. Oh, very dry. So what we're doing today, well, another coat of lacquer. Looking at it, probably, possibly, maybe would have got away with not doing that had there not been a massive run in it. Might have just polished this coat up, but there is a big run. I'm not going to do a lot of work to try and fix it, but a little bit. We'll try one more coat of lacquer. Hopefully see an improvement, even if it's not fix the problem. Just wondering whether to knock the heater off. I think I'll leave it on for the time being. Okay, there's a lot of blemishes in this surface. I'm not sure what they all are. Some of them look like little sputters and spits, maybe, of dry lacquer. Not sure if something's got in the surface from that. Right, gonna give this a rub back with I haven't set up an abrasives corner yet, so it's just gonna be whatever I've got lying around from previous jobs. And I think this red Scotch-Brite seems to be brand new, will do the job. Go with little circles. Right, what does that do to what you can see? I think it's okay. Not sure that's quite aggressive enough for what I'm doing today. Back to the first one then. I suppose that's close enough. Yeah, I mean, this is pretty tedious, to be honest. I think some power tools or air tools are going to be incoming for doing this sort of thing. An air DA sander maybe. Sure, what all these little nibs are. Oh. down there, maybe. Looks like it might have been pinholes, air bubbles in the lacquer that popped. Yeah, that sort of make, well, does that make sense? I think that makes sense for what I'm looking at. You probably avoid it by touching your work too much. Or some other of your rules, man. We don't follow no stinking rules here. No, we do, but it's getting a bit warm, so. I think maybe you can go off. Oh, it's better, isn't it? What was I doing? This side. Bit of runs going on here. Yep, bit of run going on here. You can probably see it come straight up. Sag, rather than run, I suppose. Oh no, that's still the original hole telegraphing through. Oh well, I guess they're gonna stay. Thank you. Yeah, there was a bit of, well, there is a bit of orange peel here. Or something, or maybe just dry overspray. Is that what orange peel is? Oh, I don't know. Bit of paint that's gone on, not wet. And it's dried, all dusty and bobbly. I'm not going to go crazy on it, because I'm going to go back round with the Scotch-Brite in a minute, I think. I feel like maybe I should be wet sanding. It seems to be okay. Seems to be okay. Am I rubbing on the wall? Oh no! Damage have I done? Oh, quite a lot. Oh well. There's always a danger. Gosh, I think this really is the worst surface on the box for, well, I don't know what it is. Is it pinholes? Whatever it is, kind of defect. This surface is the worst. I think some of it's dust. With an extractor and a filter, a lot of that will go away. Okay. Don't know what it means. Don't know what it means. Right. Just gonna break the surface on the corner so that the next coat will adhere properly. Try not to linger too long on it. Don't want to break through the paint. Okay. Oh, good grief. I don't know what that is. Got to break the glaze, otherwise the next coat of lacquer will just peel or pick straight off. It's getting a bit warm. Yeah, this might just be the way. Just gently. I'm still on 400 grit, which still is probably a bit too abrasive, really. Okay, I'm actually getting blue on the sandpaper now, so I'm obviously all the way through the lacquer. Maybe I just did not get a good coverage of lacquer on these, on the edges of these buttresses. I can't imagine that. I'm sure I tried to. I can tell when I break through because the white dust that's produced from sanding the lacquer starts to turn blue as some of the paint dust gets mixed in with it. So that's useful. And I don't think I'm breaking through much. I think it may have just been some lumps in the blue paint that are just sticking up a little bit proud. And I'm just getting them and they're making my lacquer powder change colour. Okay. Right. So I think my theory from last time was possibly back to front. I was going to paint the big surfaces and then go back and cut in the small bits, thinking that then the last bit of overspray, which was going on top of paint, would be going onto the big flat surfaces. But I think it's worked out the other way. I think those first bits of overspray dried. Is that what I think? Yeah, the first bits of overspray from doing the main bulk of the panels dried before I actually got the paint that was intended for that panel onto it. Maybe. Who knows? Just going to check you're still recording with my recent mishaps.
Oh yeah, 1 hour in, it's like. Maybe won't go crazy on this.
Someone coming in the front door, I think. Too much.
Cold that.
How much water have I got left?
Right, and just hope that the compressor and the kettle don't come on at the same time. I'm not sure that that would be a very good thing. Oh, crikey, cheap camping bottle. Yep, loads of grot on that surface. Loads of grot on the outside as well. That was the run, wasn't it? Know what you're thinking? That kettle boiled. Why aren't you pouring the hot water into your cup? I know. Solid work ethic, you see. Solid work. Oh, no, you know what? I'm just going to have some tea. Yes, world's hottest kettle, world's fastest cooling cup. Nice.
Right, run around the edge now. Yeah, it's getting into the corner pretty good, that. It is tough though, this finish. This top coat. Yeah. Should be quite durable. Yeah, that's where I'm through to the primer, unfortunately. Cranky, really not doing much on this. Now this surface has the look of something that happens when you paint MDF unsealed. Sort of speckly. I wonder if it's just not quite well enough sealed before it was painted. proper grot in that corner, but I think I said last time, it's a corner you're not going to see very much of. Yeah, getting to the point now, boredom's setting in, or just starting to. Luckily, I think I'm near the point where I can move on from rubbing stuff. So I need to stock up on a, oh, that's rubbish. I need to stock up on abrasives. Some wet and dry. DA sander, that'd be good. Yeah, a couple of little sanders maybe, different types. Polisher, I'll want a polisher at some point. Thank you. Well, it's payday before too long. I'll just have to keep them in mind. I should put a whiteboard up. Shopping lists, to-do lists, that sort of thing. Right. Okay. Don't want to be all day about this. Okay. Put the screws back in the holes because I don't want them to fill up with lacquer and become unusable. I'd say, do you want to look around, but you can probably see better than I can if last time's anything to go by. So many screws. Mm-hmm. I should get some background music, like like a video game. You can pretend you're playing an RPG, and I'm just an NPC. Oh no! I have a quest for you, adventurer. 50 experience points if you can find my last screw. Oh, here it is. Okay. Give it another dust. This is where that reaction was, isn't it? Where that cracking was. Put the heater on for a minute while I mess about filling the lacquer gun. Now, I tried saving some lacquer last time. Still recording. Let's see what happened to that. Where did that go? Here it is. It's jelly today, that stuff. Right. Makes sense. Oh, crikey. Dropping stuff. Get rid of the jelly, throw in a bit of thinner because I have a tub limitation. Oh no, I don't. I've got more tubs. Let's use a fresh tub. Should work out how to clean these, because otherwise I'll be going through a lot of them. Right, I mixed up way too much lacquer last time. From the looks of things, the proportions were okay. There's a good scale. Right, so... let's go 200 lacquer plus 100 hardener. Total of 300 millilitres. And more thinner or no thinner? I'm going to try no thinner today, see what happens. Oh no, that's hardener I'm pouring at the moment. Rubbish. rubbish. I need to get rid of that. Oh man. I'll never get it back in the bottle because it's a tiny little nozzle. So I'm just going to have to waste 100ml of hardener, tip it into my waste receptacle. Okay, it's a tiny bit over 100 hardener. Just thinner. It's a bit more than a tiny bit. No, it's not. No, it's not. It's about 100 to 105. So we're still going to go up to 300 total volume. I'm adding the lacquer now. Yeah, once again, it's looking a bit thick. I will put some thinner in it. I think my filter paper just broke. Oh well, we're at about the right volume now. Maybe I'll filter it into the gum. Bit more thinner. Bit of a stir. To work out how I'm going to wear all my wearables. So I think you're coming off for a second.
I'm holding the microphone. I've got eye protection this time, so that's good. Bought these new, not worn them before. See how we go. A bit tight on the glasses, but can't complain too much.
So, try and get you back in about the right place. No idea how comical that looks. I'm sure right comical is the answer. Reassemble spray gun. Feels a bit stiff. I wonder if I cleaned it out enough last time. Try and blow in a bit of thinner through it to start with. Need my nozzle. And the diffuser, or whatever it's called. Oh, okay, I just tipped out the thing. Max pressure 6 bar. So that's 6 bar. Okay. Gonna knock that down now to 1 bar, I think. One bar and the trigger's pulled. Thank you. Okay. steam. Right, you can all go in. It's fine. Oh dear, that's quite a lot. Probably a good idea to turn that off. Right. I cannot see what's happening there at all. Oh, is that better? Was it better or not? Maybe. Oh, thank you. Steven up. I think I need a bit more pressure. Oh dear. Oh, it seems to have a blockage. Yeah, right.
So I think what we have here is a failure to clean my gun properly. This is pretty unfortunate. Size I need.
Gloves, I think.
Because I think this is about to get messy.
Oh, I can't see a blockage. quite sure why that happened. It did look like that wasn't returning properly, and there was an air blockage. So it was just dribbling. Oh, had I just gone off the bottom of the scale? Ah. Oh. Oh well, all's well that ends well. Right, so jet. You in just snug needle in spring and adjuster. Sorry. Okay, here we go again. I just don't know what's going on. Obviously. It's like it's not atomizing very well.
Thank you.
Okay. Oh, broken through to primer there. I should probably stop. I'm in danger of putting far too much product on. I should have stopped. I should have stopped to buy the door, really. I'll get another coat out of that. Just in some areas. Oh dear. Huh. Safety release, I guess.
Oof, sticky. Already got a battery on it. Okay, I can't see any runs in the lacquer so far, which is going to be quite surprising. I can see that paint run still telegraphing through. That's fine. I'll live with that. Lots and lots of orange peel. I'm not sure what's going on in there. Looks like it's grabbed all the dust off the surface as it's run down, then pooled at the bottom. Interesting. Never seen that before. I wonder if that is exactly what's happened or not. Okay, well, anyway, no major runs. Nothing worse than getting the runs, is there? You know, I think I'm gonna leave it. Gonna leave it there. Been good to see you again. Hope to have you soon for tea. Ta-ra.